It's the awards season, and Joker seems to be the most popular film at this year's Baftas.
We've got the language you need to talk about this story. I'm Catherine.
And I'm Dan. New year, new look. This is News Review. Let's find out more about this story from the BBC's entertainment correspondent.
Joker's bleak depiction of the comic book character was one of last year's most controversial releases, but the film resonated with audiences, taking more than $1 billion at the box office, and it now leads the way at the BAFTAs with 11 nominations, including Best Film and Best Actor for Joaquin Phoenix.
So, you know the Oscars, you know the Golden Globes. Well, here in the UK, we have the BAFTAs. That's the British Academy for Film and Television Arts. They give awards every year at around this time. And this year, the film Joker with Joaquin Phoenix has had no less than 11 nominations. So it's very, very popular with the BAFTA people, but not all the audience, Dan, eh? What did you think of it?
Well, I know that many people love it and many people hate it. Personally, I'm actually in the middle. It was good, but in places I was bored. How about you?
Sort of same, really, although Joaquin Phoenix does... He does creepy really, really well.
Yes,
he's all slimy and horrible, wasn't he? So I was impressed by the creepiness.
Nice. Well, we've got three words and expressions that you can use to talk about this story. What do we have for them, Catherine?
We have frontrunner, we have in the spotlight, and also leads the pack.
Frontrunner, in the spotlight, and leads the pack. Okay, can we have our first headline?
Most certainly. So we're at The Guardian first. The headline, BAFTAs 2020, Joker leads pack with 11 nominations. Our vocabulary today is in the subheading, which goes like this. Supervillain story frontrunner for British Film Awards with The Irishman just behind.
Frontrunner, person expected to win a competition. Now, I can see one word, but there's two other bits inside it, obviously.
That's right. Yeah. It's a compound word. Yes, two parts to it. Front, F-R-O-N-T, and the second part, runner, R-U-N-N-E-R. Put them together, you have front runner.
Okay, so I know front is in ahead and run is in run.
Yeah.
So is it that simple, really?
Well, literally, the front runner is often in the world of horse racing, it comes from, where the horse that is running at the front of all the other horses is the front runner and is most likely to win.
So obviously applying that to different contexts, that means the one that's most likely to succeed.
The one that's most likely to succeed. The one that's doing the best is more popular, more powerful, more successful than all the other ones, and most likely to win something or get the promotion, get the job, get the recognition. That's the front runner.
Nice. So is it just sports or award ceremonies? Or?
No. Anything that's got some sort of element of competition.
Okay.
Maybe not an official competition, but something where you want to do better than others. So in the world of retail, you could say that there's a particular brand of computer that is selling many more than similar brands. The one that's selling the most is the front runner.
It's the front runner. Okay, so the front runner for, and then the category, right?
That's right, yeah.
So the front runner for the BAFTAs, or the front runner for computing, for example.
Or in computing, you could say it's a front runner in computing.
Nice.
That would be possible.
What about candidates for a job? You can use it there as well, can't you?
Front runner for the job is whoever. I'm looking at you. You've already got the job.
For the job. Yes, I've already got the job.
With the job. Front runner for your own job.
Yeah. Cool. Right, let's have a quick look at a summary slide for that information then, shall we? Okay, I think we're ready to go to our second headline now, please, Catherine.
We are ready. We are going to The Wrap. The headline is BAFTA nominations put 1917 in the awards spotlight again, and Joker 2.
In the spotlight, receiving a lot of attention. Now, there's a pun here. The BAFTAs are all about film and theatre, and we have the word spotlight,
yes,
which is
Spotlights are used in film. Baftas isn't about theatre, so is it? It's mostly film
and television.
Oh, it's television.
Yes, excuse me, you're right.
Yeah, but spotlights are used in the films and theatres and television.
Phew, I'm
spotlights.
Safe.
Spotlights. We've even got some, are they spotlights?
We've got a few spotlights over here.
There's lights.
Here, somewhere.
Spotlights in the studio.
Yeah.
A spotlight is a light that you use in film, theatre, television. It directs on one person particularly. Mm-hmm. If you turn the other lights off, there's one person is glowing in this wonderful light and you can't see anything else. So the spotlight really highlights one person and makes you look at them.
Okay, so draws all the attention
exactly
to one particular
that.
Thing.
If you're in the spotlight,
gotcha.
All the attention is on you.
Okay. Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Depends on what you've done to deserve the spotlight, yes. Mm. But in the case of this film, it's done lots of good things. It's in the spotlight because it's got 11 nominations for BAFTAs and everybody's talking about it. You might be in the spotlight because you've done something you shouldn't do.
Done something naughty at work.
Yeah, like steal biscuits, Rob.
Rob's constantly in the spotlight.
For stealing the
for
biscuits.
For stealing biscuits.
For example.
So we have in the spotlight.
Yeah.
We can also use under, right?
Can be under the spotlight as mm-hmm. well. That's a bit more of an intense kind of you're being investigated idea. But if you're in the spotlight, you've got attention for whatever reason. Yeah.
Very nice. And you can also steal the spotlight.
You can steal the spotlight if somebody's in the spotlight and you do something that takes the attention away from them and onto you. You've stolen the spotlight. Or we can also say you've stolen the limelight. That's spelled L-I-M-E. L-I-G-H-T, it's all one word. Spotlight, by the way, is S-P-O-T-L-I-G-H-T. And both of them have this idea of all the attention is on you.
Very nice. Okay, well, let's let our slide steal the spotlight from us. Can we have a look at that? So if you like vocabulary learning and celebrities, then we have a program just for you. Isn't that right, Catherine?
We do. Now, this one's all about the Emmys, another awards. And this was about a proposal of marriage that was made at the Emmys. How about that, Dan?
In front of everybody.
Apparently so.
They asked someone to marry them.
You'll have to watch the program.
How romantic.
Very romantic. Okay. Quite brave as well. If you want to see the programme, just click the link in the description. You'll go straight through to the marriage proposal or at the Emmys.
How exciting. Okay, so let's have a look at our third and final headline then, please.
Let's do that. And we're actually back to our first headline, but we're looking at a different part of it. Thank you very much. And The Guardian, BAFTAs 2020, Joker leads pack with 11 nominations.
Leads pack. Is better or more successful than competitors. Now, pack is the interesting word here, isn't it?
It is. So we've got two words, I mean, it's a two or three word phrase to lead the pack. Lead, L-E-A-D, the, obviously, and then pack, P-A-C-K. Mm. A pack is a group of animals, specifically dogs. If you have a group of dogs, they are in a pack.
And wolves too, if I'm not
wolves
mistaken.
Wolves are pack animals too. Mm-hmm. And every pack of wolves has a leader.
So that would be the biggest or the strongest or the most successful.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I think I'm getting an idea of what this means.
Yes. So in animal terms, a pack leader is the strongest, the top dog, in fact, mm-hmm. we say. If we use that in this sense, the pack, if something's leading the pack, it's ahead. It's the strongest, the most popular, the most successful, the front runner, in fact. And in this case, Joker's leading the pack of all the other films.
Yeah, because it has the most number of nominations, doesn't it?
Exactly that. Yeah.
Okay, so is this just films, or again, is this one of those expressions that we can apply to lots of different contexts?
No. Much like front runner, you can lead the pack in many different ways, in many different situations. So the most successful mobile phone is leading the pack because it's more successful than the rest. You can have somebody at work who's leading the pack, they're more successful, they get more attention, they get better results.
Mm.
So yeah, anything can lead a pack. If there's more than one person competing in directly or indirectly, the one that's the most successful, that's the pack leader, they're leading the pack.
Lovely. Well, let's go to a quick summary slide to see that information again. Now, can we recap the vocabulary, please?
Of course. We started with front runner, person expected to win a competition. We also had in the spotlight, receiving a lot of attention. And finally, leads the pack, is better or more successful than competitors.
Thank you very much. Now test yourself on that vocabulary with a quick quiz on our website. We're also all over social media, so find us there. Thank you very much for joining us, and we'll see you next time, won't we?
We will. Goodbye.
Bye, everybody.
See you soon.
Oh, hi. Thanks very much for watching our program. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm sure you did. Don't forget to subscribe so you can keep up to date with our wide variety of English language learning programs. We've got something for everyone. And that's it. We'll see you next time. I'm going to eat my bagel. Bye, guys.